Well, I have the pleasure to announce our last speaker of the day, which is Jean-Jacques Risler from the Université Paris 7.
Paris 6.
Paris 6.
Ah, oui.
And he'll talk on invariant curves for real plane analytic vector fields.
Thank you. So I will try to speak English. My English is very bad. Okay, so I'm very pleased to be here, and I choose to speak about a little result about foliations. I am not at all specialist of foliation, but I learned something about foliation when I was invited here in IMPA some years ago, and this work was done after talks with Cesar Camacho and Paulo Sade, and in fact it is a tentative to have a real analog of the Camacho-Sade result about invariant curve for vector fields. So as Servo told, I think, he told that the Camacho-Sade result was an analog of D'Alembert-Gauss theorem for polynomials. You said that. So I will. So the D'Alembert-Gauss theorem. So I put here polynomials and here vector fields in the plane or foliation. So it is gems. So the D'Alembert-Gauss theorem said that any polynomial or in C of X has a root. As a root. So here, the analog of root is irreducible invariant gem. So what I will prove, the analog of, if you take real polynomial of odd degree, then it has a real root. So I will try to do the analog here. And as you know, this theorem is much easier than this one. So that one will be much easier than that one. It will be very, but anyway, it is something. So what is the analog of real polynomial? It will be a real gem of vector field, singular at the origin in R2. And what is analog of degree? There are two candidates. So you take some vector field, let us say A plus B of dy, with, let us say, AB in R of XY, convergent power series, and you assume they have no common factor. Then you have two candidates, either nu of V, means the order of the singularity, the infimum of the order of A and B, either the Milner number, which is the dimension of this quotient ring, the intersection multiplicity of IB. And it turns out that these two analogs of the degree works. You have a theorem for each one. And what is another analogy for odd? It is even. So it is natural because so I will prove exactly that a odd degree polynomial has a real root. Okay. So let us first Let me first give some recalls and definition. The notation. So I take a gem of vector fields at zero. So what is a separatrix? It is a gem of analytic curve, maybe singular at zero, invariant by the field. So we can speak of real separatrix or complex separatrix. Then there is another notion which some body called curve characteristic curve. That means it is a trajectory which tends to zero with a tangent, but not necessarily analytic here. But which it has a tangent at zero, so it does not spiral. So you have these two notions we will deal with. And okay, so now I will recall that. Merci, j'ai rien oublié. Yeah, I will just recall the resolution of singularities because I will use it. What is a irreducible singularity for the field? It is a field or such that the linear part is non-zero, and either you have two non-zero eigenvalues, either you have one, and also you can assume that the quotient is not positive rational, either you have one zero eigenvalue, and that is called saddle nodes, as you know. Saddle nodes. Non, on dit ça? Exact?
Non.
Node. Okay. And then you have the theorem of resolution of singularities. Theorem, you have, let us say in the complex domain, a succession of explosions, blowing ups of points. Here you have this, gem of vector field, but it is the same as gem of foliations. Okay, we'll put F here. And then upstairs you have some exceptional divisor, which is P minus 1 of 0. And the foliation lift to a singular foliation on this space with the following properties. Either you have invariant, these projective lines are invariant for the extended foliation here, but maybe with irreducible singularities. Either you have components which are not invariant for the foliation, which called decritical components, and which are no singular points. Yeah. Okay. So you have that, and then in the real domain, all you can do that. Stable, all commuting with complex involution. That means all is because blowing up are defined over R. So all this situation is stable, is invariant by the complex involution. So this theorem I found in, when I was in, here in IMPA, my book of Chevet was this paper, very nice paper by Camacho, Linz Neto, and Paul Sad, where they look at topological invariants and equidistangularizations for holomorphic vector fields. And they prove that, because with this non-decritical component. So you have that, and you can take the fixed part, and then you have, let's see, S tilde. You have a real resolution. But some of these components may be complex, not real. But when you have one component complex, you have the conjugate also. Okay. So that is, and all these singularities are irreducible. Now, remark, let us put in the real case. If you have a separatrix here, which will be smooth and transversal because it is an irreducible singularity, it will project on a separatrix downstairs. All these components project to zero. And if you have a characteristic curve with a tangent here, it will project to a characteristic curve. And the Camacho-Sad theorem is just to prove that you have a singular point here, not at a corner, and which is not a saddle node. Okay. So now we will use that. And I will give one more definition. Well, I will call complex generalized curve, what they call the generalized curve. It is a gem of foliation or a vector field, such that there is no saddle node at the end of the resolution. All the singularities are nodes, like that. So that's complex generalized curve. And R, real generalized curve, the same thing, but with no real saddle node upstairs. For real generalized curve, we don't care about complex saddle nodes. Okay. So first, I will study the first generalization of the degree that is a minor number. So let us say theorem one. First, let V be an RGC. Real generalized curve. That means no saddle node in the resolution. And assume that the minor number is even, because I told odd become even. Then there exists a real separatrix. That means there exists a real gem of real analytic curve invariant by the field. And now, if you drop this hypothesis, so if you only have mu even, then there exists a generalized curve, like a characteristic curve, or characteristic orbit. Real character. So in both cases, the field does not spiral at the origin. Well, unfortunately, it is not always true that there will be a separatrix. Okay, so let us prove this theorem. You will see it's not difficult at all. But it is really an analog of the theorem about odd degree polynomials. So the K lemma is this one. Let F I will first be in the non-decritical case. Then there is a finite number of complex separatrix because there is no component with this transversal orbits. So there is a finite number of complex separatrix, maybe a priori maybe zero, because we don't use the Camacho's. I don't use the Camacho's algorithm, because for odd degree polynomial, you don't use D'Alembert-Gauss theorem. You do it at the level elementary school before. Okay, anyway, but in the mind, so I take F equation of the separatrix if there is not F equal 1. And I assume, because all situation is invariant by involution, I can assume that F is real. And F is reduced. Clear. But F is real, but maybe it has no real component. F could be x squared plus y squared. So all the goal is to prove that there is a real component and that F is not constant. So now I can define mu of F. Mu on F is dimension over R of F prime y, F prime x. It is in the index of the complexification of the field. Then the lemma is that mu of the field is congruent to mu of F mod 2. Well, it will be true also in the decritical case, but I have to use the isolated separatrix and not the separatrix. Okay, so you have that. So that is the K lemma. And now, and the hypothesis after will be that is even. Okay, so let us prove this lemma. Not difficult, but anyway. So proof. So I prove by induction on the number of blowing ups, as always, on the number P of blowing ups you need to resolve the field or the foliation. So if P equal 1, I will. If we il faut que je suppose que c'est non décritique. No, I'm sorry. I will assume that is real generalized curve first. Non-decretal case, but real generalized curve means no saddle note, no real saddle note. Okay, no, because if not, it is not true. So with real generalized curve, we have this congruence. So if P equal 1, so that means the field is solved, P equal 0, sorry, is solved, that means the singularity at 0 is irreducible. So mu of V is 1. Because you have two non-zero eigenvalues, it is like I don't know. And mu and f is like x y. It is two. You have two analytic separatrix transversal, and then mu of f is one also. So it is a. But it is not true for a saddle node, clearly. It is true for a node. Okay, so that is the first step. So now let us do a blowing up. So let us go from P minus 1 to P. So what happened? So there is a... projective line, which is a result of blowing up of zero, and with some and the foliations lift on a singular foliation with some singular points. Like that. And otherwise, this line is invariant by the field, union of trajectories, because I assume to be in the non-decritical case. Okay, so assume that these points are real, and those ones are complex. So let us lift these two numbers upstairs. So, first, let us, I call F tilde the foliation upstairs, and F the foliation here. So I have mu of V or F, mu of V. Well, it is the same as mu of the foliation downstairs, is congruent to sum of mu of f tilde at pi plus 1. Well, I will not do the computation. I found that in the Moussu Mattei paper, this Noether's formula. But it is, well, there is another term we will see for F, but it is congruent to this sum of mu plus 1. But that is congruent to sigma, to the same sum, but for the real points. Because this number of complex points is even, because it is stable by complex conjugation. So I have this, and then I will use the induction hypothesis, okay? So now, let us call GI a local equation of the separatrix at PI, like F. Okay? So I have that is by induction hypothesis. Of mu of gi plus 1, okay? That's just induction hypothesis, because here the number of p has decreased by 1. Okay, but what is gi? Here at some point p, I have this line as separatrix. So let us take coordinates, let us say, in this chart, xt, such that this line has equation x equals 0, this exceptional divisor. Then gi is x gi tilde, okay? Then now, mu of gi is congruent to mu, mu of gi tilde plus 1 mod 2. You have this formula if you want. I will quote here. Let us F some products of analytic germs. Then mu of F equals sigma of mu of Fi plus 2 sigma of intersection multiplicity minus k plus 1. So that's the computation of mu for a product. It is in, you find that. You ask to SIAD. He will explain you that. Okay, so you have that. So you, in case of that, you find that. Okay? But now, so you have that. Now, so if you want, here, it's congruent to sigma mu of g tilde plus s plus 1. Okay, now what happened? Now F, the separatrix downstairs, F, is a product of functions whose tangents correspond to points here. Because gi tilde is the strict transform of f at the point pi. So we have that. And then we apply this formula. So mu of f is congruent to sigma of mu of fi. That is even. Well, E is K, but it is same thing than S plus 1, modulo 2. But GI, GI is a separatrix here at PI. GI is a strict transform of Fi. So that is congruent to sigma of mu of Ji minus S plus 1. Because mu of Fi is mu of Ji plus mu I n minus 1, where mu I is a multiplicity. So it is even. Okay, so now you replace, you look that, but that is the same as that. Oh, I'm sorry, it is Ji tilde. Huh? It is a strict control. So that is the same modulo 2 as this one. Because minus S is congruent to plus S modulo 2. So it works. So this lemma in the non-decritical case and RGC case is proved. So now I will. So it is just a question of lift both number and be careful with parity. And we can just restrict to real part because all what is complex is even. That is exactly the philosophy. So now it is finished. Now, in the decritical case, we can assume that there is no real decritical component. Because if there was a real decritical component, each transversal orbit would give a real C-matrix by projection. So we assume there is no real decritical component. And then it is clear that this lemma is true. But here we must have the equation of isolated separatrix. That means separatrix which don't meet this component. And then all what is complex is even. So if, again, this lemma is true. So now what happens? You have this formula. Mu of F equal 2 delta minus R plus 1. Delta is an invariant of singularity, it's an integer, number of double points you find in some mortification of the singularity. So if mu of V is even, mu of F is even, then we come to odd, then R is odd. That is the number of branches, number of irreducible components. So if you have an odd number of components, at least there is one. So there is a separatrix, and there is one real, because the complex ones go by pairs. Okay, so that is the first case for the theorem, when it was RGC. So now what happened in the general case? Namely with saddle nodes. If you have a saddle node in the resolution somewhere, what is a saddle node? Saddle node, you have always an analytic separatrix, smooth, tangent to the eigenvalue space for the non-zero eigenvalue, and a formal analytic separatrix, transversal, which could be or not convergent. But anyway, if this separatrix is not convergent, you always have a characteristic curve which go to zero. So now you have, for a saddle node, let us say Q here. So you have two integers. You have this is the analytic separator. This is a formal one, E2. And you have that the multiplicity, let's see, of the foliation in relation to E1 at the point Q is 1 restriction, because it is multiplicity 1. And here you have a number. Which could be, well, which for a standard knot is strictly greater than 1. That's the multiplicity of this formal separatrix at the point Q. So now you have to. What happened? First, if you have in the resolution, if you have a saddle knot Q here, not at the corner, so okay, you maybe you have no convergent separatrix, but you have a characteristic curve real. So downstairs you have a characteristic curve. Because here you have a tangent by projection. But when I made my first talk on this topic at Rennes, Dominique Servo said, well, you could have a saddle knot at a corner. That was, for me, unthinkable. So you could have so if you have a saddle knot at a corner, you are in a bad situation, because here you have two convergent separatrix, and maybe, so you have this situation at the corner, and maybe if Q is even, the flow is something like that. You have no more trajectory going to the point Q. Because non. Q, c'est ça? Wait a minute. Oui, comme ça. The flow going like that. So that is a c'est ça? Non, c'est Q odd. Oui, pardon. Je me trompe? Non, c'est bien ça. Là, ça. Comment? Ah non, là ça va. Non, c'est Q odd. Oui, oui, comme ça. Ah, d'accord. Oui, mais ça, c'est Q odd. I'm sorry. It is Q odd. I mixed the odd and even. No, if Q is odd, you may be like that, and there is no more characteristic curve. Otherwise, if Q is even, you will have always characteristic curve anyway. So, for the theorem, we want to prove that there is a characteristic curve. We can assume that for all the saddle knots, which appear, then they are at corners. That means you have two analytic separatrix, and the number Q is odd. Okay. But for such a saddle knot, Q is a mu number of the foliation at Q. Locally, here, because that one and that is Q. Okay, and it turns out that if all the saddle knots are like that, then the lemma is again true. This lemma is true if all the saddle knots have two analytic separatrix and multiplicity or mu number odd. Why? Because in the first So I will put there. So lemma is true. Because if you look at the proof, proof was by induction of the number of blowing ups. In P, if P is zero, then you are in the saddle node situation. It is solved, maybe. So if you have a saddle node here with one here and Q there, mu by hypothesis is odd. So is one. But you have two analytic separatrix by hypothesis. Then mu of f is one. So the first step, they are not equal, but they are congruent mode two. And then the proof is exactly the same. This kind of miracle. It is the right parity. So it works. So in this case, you will have an analytic separatrix because the lemma is true also. Okay, so in any other case, we'll have a characteristic curve. So now, bon ben, ça va, I will just quote theorem 2. So I have the same theorem for multiplicity. Theorem 2. So first, take F or RGC, real generalized curve, with multiplicity even. Then it has a real analytic separatrix. And two, again, without this hypothesis, then you have a real characteristic. That means it is not something like that. So it is exactly the same theorem, but with mu replaced by nu. Exactly the same. And the proof I will not make is even easier than the other one, because quasi all the works is made in this paper, where they prove that the resolution of the separatrix in the complex generalized curve is the same as the resolution of the field of the foliation. You have formula for the multiplicity, and you apply it, just apply. Okay, and you have the same kind of thing for saddle knot. So let me give some example, and then ask some question. So examples. Donc je prends mon papier, ce que je vais me planter. I will plant me without my paper. First, let us take this field. So mu, the multiplicity is one. Mu equal one. So by chance, we are not in the hypothesis of this theorem. And clearly, there is no characteristic curve because trajectories are circles. Okay. You have no separatrix. Okay, second. Let us then this example. Kindly given to me by César. You make it in the metro, no? In Paris, remember. So this, for this vector field, mu is 2, clearly. And mu is 8, if you compute. But if you blow up origin, so let us take the exceptional line, you find the following differential equation or vector field. So here I will put t axis. So x dot is minus t2x plus x3. T dot is t plus x plus t3. Anyway, you have three singular points here, the origin, the minus I plus I. These two points are nodes, but they are complex. So you have two complex conjugate separatrix, and this one is a saddle node, real saddle node. So you have a characteristic curve, but not analytic separatrix. But I did not check that this characteristic curve is not convergent. So you have to ask to, generically it is not convergent. So anyway, it will be easy to find an example with not convergent separatrix, formal separatrix. So it is a counterexample, an example that you can do better for these theorems, because all is even and you have no analytic separatrix, real analytic. Okay, CERN. CERN, it is easy to see that these two hypotheses are independent. Find one vector field with new even and new odd or contrary. So there are two theorems independent. Four. What to do best? Is it possible to have a necessary or sufficient conditions to have a real separatrix? Have some, because that is only sufficient conditions. So, I don't know. It would be necessary to have a real theory of Camacho-Sat index, but I modulo 2. But since they are not integers, the Camacho-Sat indexes, I tried a little bit. I don't know. You must have a Camacho-Sat theory modulo 2 somehow, some analog, to have necessary or sufficient condition. But I did not succeed, so I don't know. Otherwise, you should find some quadratic form in the ring, maybe in this ring, or maybe in this ring with AB, or maybe some ring, and with signature, and with the parity of signature, you can find exactly if you have the number of real roots, like in Levin, l'autre là, l'autre rigolo là, le chanteur, Eisenbud, like in Eisenbud Levin spirit, but I don't know. Maybe it is possible, but I don't know. Okay, anyway, so necessary. It exists for polynomials. You have a quadratic form in the quotient ring. You take the trace of the multiplication by x on the quotient ring, and you look at the signature, and then you can compute exactly the number of real roots. That exists. It's not difficult. It was Hermite theorem or something. So you can compute the number of real roots computing the signature of quadratic form in the ring quotient ring R of x by the equation of the by the polynomial. So I don't know. Five. Since for foliations, codimension one foliation in R3. in R3, you have a resolution of singularity theorem and also the existence of complex separatrix by Servo and Cano, Felipe Cano. I think it will, in C3, I think this theorem could be generalized in this way. Find the algebraic condition of the on the form, which implies that you have real separatrix. And maybe with a student of Cano, we try to do that in Paris. We will see. I think it should work. Since you have the resolution of singularity, the same philosophy, you take a plane section, you use that for a plane section, and then you glue up. It is what they do in the complex case. So you must have a condition which implies this kind of condition for the generic section, plane section. Bon, anyway. So I will finish the... I will just ask last question. In this paper, so the three Brazilian guys, no, you are Brazilian now, I don't know. Well, three Brazilian guys, and also you are Brazilian? Well, I don't know. Anyway, the three guys from IMPA, they look at the invariance of some invariance by homeomorphism, local homeomorphism, which send leaf to leaf. So I tried a little bit to do the same in the real case, and it is very bad in the real case, very difficult. So I will give one example, because I will finish. First, so I take R2, 0, some homeomorphism, let us say, which send leaf to leaf. So, I take two singular foliations, gem of singular foliations, like that. So, first, clearly, mu mod 2, well, I did not write, but I think mu mod 2 is preserved. Because mu is a complex index of the complexification, so the real index, which will be a topological invariant, is mod 2 equal to mu mod 2, because it is the real part. So that will work for mu mod 2. But now, look at this example. You take the foliation y. The levels of this function. So it is topologically trivial on R. But multiplicity, clearly, it is homeomorphic to multiplicity and mu and nothing is preserved. Just mu mod 2. Because it is, when it is irreducible, here, mu is even. Because p and q are prime. So you must do something. So maybe for multiplicity, well, it is not known that in the complex domain, multiplicity is topological invariant, which, in my opinion, is a kind of scandal. I think somebody here should prove it, because in the plane. So you prove only for generalized curve, but it's not not fair. It's not a good proof, because you take the separatrix. So that, I don't know, should be done. The problem is that this homeomorphism does not lead to resolution. So, well, anyway. So, but maybe if phi is B by Lipschitz, or C1 if you want, but maybe B by Lipschitz, in the real domain, mu mod 2 is preserved. But I made something in the paper, but I have a hypothesis very strong. Well, I think that is, the problem is this one. If you take level of a function, irreducible real function like this one, so here, if you look at the leaves nearby, you can read the multiplicity. Because if you take here very far distance epsilon, here you have epsilon power 1 over nu. The multiplicity pushes the leaf very far from the singular point. So with some constant, clearly, because. So with a bi-Lipschitz homeomorphism, this exponent will be preserved. So you will find multiplicity. But now, if you have a foliation, which is not a function, how do you read multiplicity in the leaves? You should have some density of the leaves here, which is less when multiplicity is big, something like that. But I don't did not succeed to. There is surely something to do with density of leaves. I don't know. Here they are more dense than here. Okay, so that is a question, and I finished. I killed any older. Okay.
Très bien. La cette question que tu as posée sur les théorèmes de la vie réelle, c'est résultat pour les polynômes et dans